We must be saved, and that is Jesus Christ. The fact is, one die, one day, everybody here standing will see death. Everybody is going to die once, and the Bible says it's appointed for men to die once, and then the judgment. There will be a judgment upon your life. You will stand before a holy God, and you will give an account for your life lived on this earth. God is giving you time to come to Him. Jesus loves you. Jesus died for you. He took your wrath, He took your pain, and He took your sin at Calvary. He shed His precious blood so that you could have eternal life. God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, that whoever believes in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. God did not come down to this earth to call the righteous to repentance. He came down to save sinners. This world is full of sin. Week in, week out, people are breaking the law. The police cannot cope with this. But Jesus says in the last days, there shall be lawlessness in the last days. Lawlessness. No respect for the law. No respect for authority. People will be doing whatever they want to do, and law and order will break down. This is a sign of the last days. Jesus says, repent and believe the gospel. God loves you. That's why He sent Jesus to die for your sin. Thank you.
It's good news. It's good news for you. It's good news.
Gareth was an electrical engineer. He had earned good money. Gareth used to love on a weekend looking on his computer, his online bank account.
It's good news, sir.
Just one or two?
Yeah, one.
Money he had in the bank. My friend Gareth, like a lot of people, maybe you, maybe one of the coppers. Or maybe one of you guys going in to watch the fight. Maybe you wonder, with the money you've got, why you've got an empty heart. No good having your bank account full to the brim, your heart's empty. That's no good. Jesus told the story when...
It's good news for you. Tom to Jesus Christ.
Maybe you can identify with him. This guy was a farmer. He owned a lot of land. And this one year, the climate was great. He had a bumper harvest. And he said to himself, what should I do with all of my bonus money? All of the overtime money, what should I do with it? And he made a bad decision. Bad decision. He said to himself, and this was a story that Jesus told. This guy said to himself, I know what I'll do with my big bonus. I'll build a big new barn and put all
today.
My produce in there.
Okay, would it be quite busy then?
And then I can retire.
Oh, okay.
You look into your
No. Thank you.
You made a bad decision. The Lord Jesus said, God came to that man and said, you fool.
It's good news for you, sir.
For this night your life is required of you. And he will get all of your money, all of your stuff. My friend, you and I do not know when our time will come, but I know this.
It's good news for you. Yep.
In Leeds, someone will top themselves, probably a man. This night, some people in Leeds will die, and tomorrow they won't be here. They'll be in the courtroom of their maker. You and I, my friends, are
it's good news. Yep.
Our days are numbered.
Yes, good news.
God holds that number. He knows when your time will come.
It's good news for you.
Maybe it's tonight. Maybe it's next week or next year. God is giving you time to turn to Him. Come to the Lord Jesus. You think than that latest disaster. It's just a random event. That divorce, that abortion, that tragedy, personal tragedy in your life, my friend, it's not random. God's allowed it so that you can come to your senses. Wake up, smell the alfalfa. Take account of your life before your maker. That is why God allows things to happen in this world, my friend. Your maker, the God we worship and know as our Father, loves you. But you've got something that you're accountable for. It's called your choices. How you exercise your free will. You've got to draw near to God and then he'll respect you. Don't imagine you can continue to ignore your maker and things will go okay for you.
It's good news for you, sir. Thank you. Come to Jesus Christ.
It's not some, you know, there's no reason for it. There's a reason, my friends, why you're empty in your heart. Why you're depressed. There's a reason why people commit suicide. Why they do overtime and all overtime. They're trying to...
It's good news for you, turn to Jesus Christ. Yes, turn to Jesus Christ.
Thank God in your life, my friend. There's no purpose in life whatsoever. But today,
you know the buses that run, we came in, we did a park and ride.
Yeah, we did same.
Oh, do you know what time to finish at? No?
I think it's they go on.
Later on, yeah, all night.
The Lord Jesus,
where did you park up then?
Very close to in the park and ride. Just close to the...
Just a few park and rides. Are you on that?
Do you want Elland Road? Do you want on Elland Road?
Elland
Stadium. That'll be good.
Mental health issue, whatever you've got, come to the Lord Jesus. His requirement is simple. You've got to change your mind.
Turn to Jesus Christ, turn to Jesus Christ, turn to Jesus Christ. Repent.
Jesus is a false idol.
Jesus is the only way. Okay, have a read. Yeah, it's okay.
Hold on 2 seconds.
Yeah.
Jesus is a false idol.
No.
Given divinity in the 12th century by Rome.
No.
Yeah? Jesus is a false idol.
No. In Ethiopia, Jesus Christ.
He was given divinity.
Watch the Pope. They just want to talk and walk away.
Oh, man. You know what it says? That God laughs at those who plan against him. And God laughs at it.
He have them in derision.
Wicked. You know, I think I figured out what is pride in people. They're pride because of their own idols. They are God themselves.
Yes.
And they don't want...
They've made a God in their own image.
I'm wondering, that frame of mind is very difficult for them to come back from that, because
they'll have to let go of so many things.
Yeah.
It's good news for you, sir. Good news, yes.
Religion doesn't cut it. Religion is just a human effort. Forget about religion. There's no point saying there is no God. That's a non-starter. God calls the person, if you're one of them, listen closely. If you say there is no God, the Bible calls you a fool.
It's good news for you. Yes. It's good news. Yes. Thank you. It's good news for you, sir. Good news. Yes. 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 It's good news for you. It's good news. Good news for you. Turn to Jesus Christ.
My friend, today, the way to know God is your Father. You're not on about religion here.
It's good news, good news, good news. Yes, yes, good news for you. Turn to Jesus Christ. It's good news for you. Repent and turn to Jesus Christ.
Such a great sacrifice for your soul. Don't do that. That's a bad idea.
The best way to describe it, think of an archer, Robin Hood if you want, gone wrong. Takes out his arrow and his bow, fires it, he totally misses.
Yeah, it's a good way to reach people also.
It's a, yeah,
it's a good way.
You're still getting the word across, you're getting the message. Yeah. Without Jesus,
you totally miss. It's good news. Hello. Humanity.
I love planting seeds, don't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, yeah, I love planting yeah. seeds. Some, I think it's actually one of the best ways.
Oh, yeah.
Because there's no excuse. They will hear you clearly.
That's it.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. It's good news for you.
Where freedom is, I'm free.
The ingrain food on the inside, it's all dried out, the oil. Would take an hour sometimes to clean two pots on the inside, scrubbing with iron, that kind of steel cloth, applying chemicals, scrubbing it an hour to get the inside of that pot clean so the chef can put the lovely food in for the next night. But my friend, when you come to the Lord Jesus, his blood can wash, cleanse you on the inside. But if you'll humble yourself before your Maker, he'll respect you and he'll do what the Bible says. He'll answer the cry of your heart. My friend, God answers prayer, but it's prayed from the heart. The promises of God is one of them. Whoever calls upon the name of the Lord Jesus, I will hear and answer. Many years ago, God spoke to Isaiah the prophet.
Yes! Yes! No, I'm all right, sir.
You said yes, yes. Turn to Jesus Christ, repent and be saved. You need Jesus Christ.
You're lost without him, sir.
No, for Jesus Christ, shit me.
Well, you're free to do that, by the way.
We warned you, right? We warned you when you're going to hell.
We warned you, bro.
A chance with God if you will humble yourself. The Lord Jesus came to seek and to save.
It's good news for you, sir. Turn to Jesus Christ, repent and be saved. It's good news for you. Turn to Jesus Christ, repent and be saved.
You might have a big house, but you'll be alone, wandering around. Have you ever wondered why all these billionaires end up eventually trying to give away their money? They end up being philanthropists. Have you noticed that? Most of them, they earn billions and then eventually the penny drops and they realise they've got no peace of heart. And all of their money cannot buy it. Of course it can. Peace, purpose, joy that bubbles up on the inside does not come from status or money or a big bank account. No, it comes from the Lord Jesus. Because the Lord Jesus puts you back in contact with your dad, your father. And you're back in where you were made to be in the family of God. Calling upon your Maker as your Father. Come tonight, my friend. Maybe you can enjoy a fight, but let me tell you, the only permanent happiness on the inside is when you discover the Lord Jesus. There's no other permanent solution to our human condition. We are born in sin, missing the mark, with no idea how to live a good life. The only way is to consider this man Jesus. Maybe some of you have tried it and you found it too difficult. Let me tell you, it isn't easy to face up to who you really are. It's not easy. The only way you can do it is look. Continue to look, seek the face of this Saviour Jesus. He is humble of heart. He knows what you've gone through. Look at him and he'll melt your heart and you'll be able to let go of either your pride or your fear. That's the only way. You've got to seek the Lord, and he promises. Jesus says, seek me and you'll find me. And let me tell you, you will find him if you'll seek him. Pay the price. Make the sacrifice. Put Jesus Christ first. Seek him and you will find him. Guaranteed. God has guaranteed all of his promises in the death and resurrection of the Lord Jesus. Muhammad didn't do that for you. In fact, Muhammad never promised to forgive your sin, but the Lord Jesus does. He cleanses, washes, removes our sin. Even when we've lived in bad faith towards our Maker or our fellow man, when you humble yourself, he'll forgive you. It's called mercy. Mercy is getting what we don't deserve. That is what Jesus offers on the cross. Forgiveness. A new start. We don't deserve it, but Jesus died in our place. The Son of God, my friend, became the Son of Man so that you and I might become sons of God, back in the family where we were created to be, God's family. My friend, today, come to the Lord Jesus. He'll give you a new start, pardon you. Bring all of your messed up life, your addictions.
Tony, God bless you, sir.
We're going to make our way back.
Yes, thank you very much.
Bring all of your sin.
My regards.
Bring it.
Bye. Bye.
And come to Jesus.
Yes.
And tell him how sorry you are. And my friend, he will do business with you. He will do business with you. There's only one place to do business with God, and that's at the cross. That's at the cross. It's a place of humiliation where Jesus was humiliated so that you can experience glory and peace and joy without the shame and the guilt. Jesus did it in your place, my friend. The rejection, spat upon, punched in the face for you and I so that we can be accepted. The only place to find peace with God is the Lord Jesus. It's not religion. Don't care what religion you are. Religion is not a book. The Lord Jesus. And you and I are unholy.
It's good news for you, sir. It's good news. Turn to Jesus Christ. Good news for you, sir. Yep.
But as well, do not imagine God's an idiot. The Bible says, do not be deceived. God cannot be mocked. Carry on making the kind of decisions you've been making, excluding your Maker, rejecting him, and you'll get the same fruit. What you sow, you reap. Make a bad decision, get a bad result. Keep on making your bad decisions and you'll carry on the way you are. You've got to make a different decision, my friend. You've got to turn back.
Yep.
And look at the salvation offered in the Lord Jesus. I am the way, the truth and the life, Jesus said. The word of God says salvation is found in no other name under heaven given to by God to you and I, except the name.
It's good news.
God is not a skin zone. God's not got a personality to do that.
It's good news
for
you.
No mental health issue with our Maker. He's not struggling to rule the world, but he does speak.
It's good news. Thank you.
To one of us. Maybe a relative of yours has invited you to church, or a colleague at work has shared what Jesus has done for them.
It's good news.
Take notice, because you're on probation. You've got no depression.
It's good news. Yes. Turn to Jesus Christ. Repent and say, turn to Jesus Christ.
Today, my friend, to turn to the Lord Jesus. Enjoy your fights tonight. But when you get back home and you lay in your bed wondering what life is all about, remember this. It's all about the Lord Jesus and your need to make a decision for him. God bless you today.
Yes, there's a free ticket here. Turn to Jesus Christ, yes. Jesus Christ is the only way, the truth and the life. Repent and be saved.